people, welcome here. Let's see how to use the expert workspace in Adobe Photoshop Elements 12. Please watch this video if you already know the basis of this software. The expert workspace is used to edit a photo in 2D. Differently than the other workspaces, you will have full control on any adjustment or effect applied. This is pretty similar to Adobe Photoshop. On the left you have all the tools available here. As seen in the quick workspace, the tool options below show the settings of each tool. More on the left you can change the tool itself. If a tool button has a small black corner, it means that contains more than a single tool. The first group of tools is used to view better your image, the zoom and the end tools. However, you don't need to use these buttons. You can activate them anytime. Hold down and use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Hold space down to move through parts of the image you want to see. The second group is dedicated to selections. Selections set an area where any correction or effect must be applied. All outside the selected area won't change at all. Use the Rectangular Marquee tool to set a simple rectangular area. You can add new areas holding Shift down. You can delete parts selected holding Hold down. A plus or a minus will appear in your pointer. Then you have the lasso tools. You have three kinds of them. The lasso tool is a freehand selection. The magnetic lasso tool is more guided since it sets the contours according to how colors change rapidly. Click to set fixed anchors. Double click if you want to close the selection area. The polygonal lasso tool works the same, but you have to set anchors always manually. The selected area will be totally decided on your own and will always have straight sides. Then you have the advanced selections. These are important in case you need to select two difficult parts to be made manually. The quick selection is a selection made auto, but you decide where brushing on. Use the undo button to retry your latest brush. The selection brush sets the selected area depending on where you brush, so you don't set the contours but the area in full. Nothing is automatically included by the software. Magic Wand is totally auto and selects areas where the color is more or less the same. Remember to hold down to remove any selection. You can move the selection clicking inside and dragging elsewhere. The third group has tools used to make adjustments that don't change the photo as it is. We have already seen the first two in the beginner tutorial. The other tools below were included in a guided workspace, although you couldn't use them directly. The Smart Brush tool sets a kind of adjustment that can be chosen through the tool options below, for example increasing contrast or adding colors. This adjustment is put where you brush. Smart Brush usually covers a full area auto starting from your brush. If you want to apply the adjustment just on where you brush, use the Detail Smart Brush. Then you have the Stamp tools. Clone Stamp works just like the Healing Brush tool. Pattern Stamp does the same, but takes and serves the pattern chosen in the tool options. More at the bottom, you have other free brush tools used to adjust photos. Blur tool makes less defined contours and contrasts appearing on the image. Sharpen does the opposite. Use the smudge tool to take pixels of the image to brush them elsewhere. The other icon includes other free tools to adjust delicately colors without ruining them. Try them out. The fourth group is used exclusively for art designs, using the colors appearing below. The color more on the left is the foreground color, used for brushes, whereas the other one is the background color, that will replace the other one if you click on the small double arrows. Click on the square to set the color. You can use the color picker tool to pick a color from the image itself. To brush, you can use the pencil tool if you want a decisive stroke. To set a brush with some feather or personalized, use the brush tool. Below you have other tools. You can choose between brush and airbrush mode. The second one differs from the first one, since the stroke is defined depending on how much you hold on a point. Impressionist brush tool mixes up pixels of the image. Use color replacement tool to brush using the color set, but keeping contours and edges of the image. Use the paint bucket tool to spread color on an area where the original color is more or less the same. Gradient tool is used to add gradient. Try it out. Use custom shape tool to add shapes onto your image. Use the eraser to clear pixels. This is used to show what's below the selected layer. Use the text tool to add some text. This works just like the one seen in the quick workspace. If you are in distress, watch the beginner tutorial of this series. To manage shapes and text, you can use the move tool or hold Ctrl down. The last group of tools are special tools Photoshop Elements has. The crop tool is the same of the quick workspace. Recompose tool crops the image, but without cutting parts off. New in Photoshop Elements 12 is the content-aware move tool. Simply select a part of the image you want to move. Then drag and move it. The software will place the selected part in place, covering the vacant part left. This tool is cool as long as you move subjects that aren't too big in the image. Let's see what's on the right. At the bottom you have different buttons. The most important ones are the Layers and Effects button. In the expert mode, Photoshop Elements works with layers. These are levels, one upon each other, containing one or more objects or pieces of images. By default, the images are indicated through a layer plus a number as a name, that you can change double-clicking on such. If you create a vector shape, the vector layer will be named as a shape plus a number, with the shape represented on the left. The text has the layer named with the text content itself, with a big and gritty icon on the left. These layers are managed in the same way. Click and drag a layer to pull it up or down. This sets which objects must stay on others. A layer put on top has objects that are shown on the objects that stay in lower layers in the order. Click on two or more chain icons to link more layers at the same time. For example, if you want to move together the shape and the text, click once again to unlink layers. Click on the eye to hide or show a layer and its objects inside. On top, change the opacity percentage to add some transparency to a layer. Use the lock icon on top to lock a layer. In this way, it can't be moved, edited, or modified in any way. How about effects? There are two ways to add them here. If you want to add effects to layers, go in the second icon from the left. In this way, you will add an adjustment layer that sets the effect chosen. This layer affects the area selected at the moment. This can be seen through the sample image too. The white side is the affected side, whereas the black one is where the adjustment is not applied. You can click on the adjustment icon to open its window again and adjust its settings. Remember that the adjustment layer affects just the white area and just all the layers that are put lower in the list. So all layers above don't get any effect from the adjustment layer. Delete any layer, right-clicking on it or going to the bin button on top. Then there are defects that are applied on objects. Click on the FX icon at the bottom and choose between filters, styles and effects on top. Select one of the available effects and drag it onto your workspace. This effect will be applied on the selected area of the selected layer. You may need to hide adjustment layers active to make it work. There are plenty of other effects you can apply. For example, go to Filter and select one. Depending on the effect, a different window appears, making you set options. Experience and practice will guide you at which effect is the best for you. Thanks for watching this video. Check our channel to get more into professional softwares. Bye!